Philippines. Thanks for joining us. I'm Rico Bison. The Banco Central ng Pilipinas, Governor Felipe Medalla, announces with certainty there will be another interest rate hike when the Monetary Board meets on August 18th to stem rising inflation. In its June meeting, the central bank raised its inflation forecast to 5% this year. Medalla says the 2023 inflation estimate is again up for review, and the chances are now higher that it could be lower than 4%, an improvement from its current estimate of 4.2%.
We now have a better than 50-50 chance to do lower than 4. And that's why we are doing 25 or 50 next meeting, to make sure that enough follow through for that to happen. Because we're quite confident there's still sufficient momentum for growth. Now, what if I'm wrong? I still won't regret it, because GDP growth is not one of our three pillars.
The Banco Central has rallied the support of bankers to convince lawmakers to amend a near 70-year-old bank secrecy law which prohibits inquiries into bank deposits without a court order. The law is considered among the world's most prohibitive and not at par with international standards. Here's a recap now of today's market action. The Philippine Stock Exchange Index recovered as investors await the July inflation and more details in June quarter earnings this week. Most indices closed higher, led by mining and oil. The top advancers were Ayala Corporation, Semirara Mining and Power, and Ayala Land. Here now are the top stories from the Business Mirror. The Employers Confederation of the Philippines says micro, small, and medium enterprises should have access to interest-free, no collateral loans to boost economic recovery. The Japan International Cooperation Agency, or JICA, says it is promoting the Philippines' public-private partnership projects to Japanese companies. And SM Investments Corporation says it got the green light from the Securities and Exchange Commission to acquire the 81% stake of All First Equity Holdings, the holding firm of the Philippine Geothermal Production Company. And this means SMIC will fully own the geothermal operator. This file sharing tool is among the top applications in the country based on monthly active users. Now, Shared Philippines looks into using its platform to uplift local startups. We find out just how from country director Lester Lim. Lester, thank you so much for joining us. So explain to us, how is Shared helping local brands, micro small enterprises, startups reach their audience?
All right. Good evening, Rico. Well, with Shared, as its core, we're a file sharing app in itself. And being on the all-in-one app, we've amassed over 40 million mobile active users already in the Philippines alone. And that ecosystem, generally, is something that brands can leverage on in terms of speaking to certain audiences, whether in the e-commerce, fintech, and the different verticals, essentially, that they can leverage on with the different solutions to make sure that they reach the right audience and they reach the right metrics as well on their end.
Give us some key examples, Lester, on how Shared has helped companies grow their consumer base.
Right, sure. Okay, so with Shared, it's quite different in the sense that because we are a file sharing group, users essentially go to Shared to ask their friend if they can get an e-wallet app, if they can get an e-commerce app from one phone to another, and through Shared, that's possible. So that journey itself is quite unique, and brands can leverage on that to make sure that they reach the right user base in terms of what sort of interest that they have on their phones, and that enables them to essentially have a result in terms of their purchases.
I want specifics. Maybe you could give us three local companies that have had massive success using your app here in the country.
Sure, yeah. So we've partnered with the largest e-wallets in the Philippines already. So there you go. We have GCash, we have Maya.
These are the big companies, Lester. These are the big companies. What about micro small enterprises that have succeeded using your application?
Okay. Yeah. So we've actually helped with some of the burgeoning startups in the Philippines. So the likes of Edamama is one example where they focus a certain niche base in the Philippines, and with the solutions within the app itself, they're able to find the right audience that will be able to convert into engaging users for their own ecosystem.
Yeah, I was talking to quite a number of venture capitalists and angel investors over the past couple of weeks, and they told me that over the past 2.5 years, we've seen a boom, right, in startup companies, many Filipino entrepreneurs. Don't want to work anymore from 9 to 5. They want to create their own business, their own company, and succeed in their own way. They want to make it big, but many of them also fail. So if they go to Sharon, how do you guide them really to succeed to that next level? Right.